Hello, YouTube.
Right, somebody asked me how to fix a damaged cable on the front wheel of their scooter. I have one into repair today, so I thought I'd just record it and talk you through it. It's pretty much the same for any scooter motor. Just going to start by removing the wheel. Take the old wheel off, and you would need to release the cable from the controller, so that'll mean opening the scooter. As we open the scooter, we need to find the cables that lead to the motor. So there'll be three thick cables and a clip that's got five cables on it. So here's the clip, take that apart. And there we go, one, two, and three thick cables, and that's that cable released. So we can pull that back through the frame and out. So now the motor should come away. So now we're open my desk. So as we can see, that's where the damage is. We're going to release the screws that hold the cover for the motor on. Now, obviously different motors, different amount of screws, but all generally the same idea. Once these screws are removed, it will still be tricky to take the cover off. The magnets hold it on, and there's sometimes a layer of glue. So we'll use some screwdrivers or something just to pry it open, and eventually it'll just release. That's it released. So we can lift that cover away and see what's going on inside. All I'm going to do is, because there's plenty of cable, I'm going to try and cut the cable where it is and feed some more through, leaving the connectors as they are and some doing some joins inside before the original connections. What I'm going to do is, I'm just going to snip the old cable off there, and what I need to do is get this mess of old cables out of the hole, which can be pretty tricky. But I'm going to pull them and manage to get the cables out, but the rubber sheath is still there, so I need to get that out somehow. All I'm doing to do that is, I'm driving a screw in there to try and grab it, and then I will use something to pull the screw out, and the rubber cable sheathing will come with it. So next, I'm going to feed the nicely cut cable back through the hole, and then I will need to strip the ends of all the cables, getting them ready to make joints. I'm ready to make my joins now. I've stripped my cable. I'm going to put some heat shrink tubing over all the cables that I'm going to join. On these thick ones, I'm going to strip a little bit of cable back so I can bind some together. A nice strong join. Just twisting them together to make sure they're nice and strong. Folding it flat. And I'm going to use some solder, my soldering iron. Add some solder to that joint. Just making sure it's super strong. Next, for the smaller cables, again putting heat shrink tubing over them before I start. On these ones, I'm just going to strip both sides and I'm going to add some solder to one of the sides. What I'll do then is join the two near each other and just add warm the solder so that they join. I'll then use the heat sink tubing as well to give it a second layer of joint. It's all done. I'm just going to use my hot air gun to heat all this tubing and then pack everything away nice and tight. Now I'm just reapplying some of the glue. I removed some silicone glue when I started, so I'll put that back in. So we should leave it pretty well sealed. I'll also put a little bead around the edge before I put the cover back on to give it a layer of water protection. So, ready to put the wheel back on. Reconnect the cable and try it. Right, scooter back on, spin the wheel, and yep, there we go. Another scooter fixed. Hope that helps you. Thank you.